lights off. Guys, this is it. Alright, we've made it. This is the last final assembly that we're going to have. Alright, this is the Year 12 assembly brought to you by Xing Li, the host.
And me, Jimmy Lam. And I can't fathom it, the fact that this is our last ever chapel assembly.
Yeah.
Mix of both, chapel assembly. And I guess what can we really say here, man? Like, just it'll be our last time seeing you guys. The next time we see you guys is gonna be in the English exam. Unless y'all are doing literature, then I don't know what you guys are doing.
Yeah.
But yeah.
It's really coming to an end, alright? I want you to look at the ones close to you, turn around, say them, I appreciate you, right? This is just a good time, guys. You're not gonna have this anymore, and please just do your thing. And now we're gonna have Pastor Jonah to come pray with us. To give us a message.
Lads, how you doing?
Yeah.
Doing good, sir.
You guys can't see this, but before we started, these lads were all funny, joking around, smiles on their faces. As soon as the stream went live, I saw their faces drop, and I saw the emotion come in.
It's the moment of realization. Like it doesn't actually kick in until the camera's on.
Yeah.
It's weird.
Yeah, this is a countdown to the end as well. After this is done, everyone's leaving.
Look, this is 13 years that you guys have been at school, coming to an end. A new season of your life about to start, a new journey. We're going to miss you at Gilson. We want all of you to know that. We're going to miss all of you. You've been a special part of our time as staff here. And we really feel for you about the last 2 years and what that's been like for you in your final year of school. But we're proud of you, okay? We want you to know. Not just you two lads. I mean, I'm not proud of your dress today.
Yeah, we're proud of you too.
But we're proud of who you are as people. Can't wait to see where you guys go. So I just wanted to say that to you on behalf of the chaplaincy team, on behalf of the staff. In fact, I want to share a verse with you. I was only asked to pray, but too bad. I'm a preacher to you anyway. I want to share a verse with you, and it's something that I've held on to since I was at school when I graduated and I was your age. It's found in 1 Timothy 4, verse 12. It says, "Do not let anyone look down on you because you are young, but set an example to the believers in speech and life and faith and love and in purity." And I love that verse because, you know, you guys are young. I'm still young too. And sometimes it feels like we're too young to do things, we're too young to achieve things, but honestly, you guys are going to do so many awesome things in your future. We can't wait to see where you go. And the verse says to be an example to others. And I believe that in order for people to stop looking down on us and to stop saying we're not good enough, we have to set the example. We have to show them that we are good enough. And I believe that all of you are. And I can't wait to see where you go. Can't wait to see what you do. Make sure you come back and visit. Because we're going to miss you. But let me pray for you guys just before you start your final chapel today. Yeah. Heavenly Father, I just want to thank you for our Year 12 students. They have been a blessing to our school. We love them a lot, and we're going to miss them. And so we pray, Lord, that as they leave school today, that you will go ahead of them, that you will direct them and guide their paths. We may not be with them each day in the future, but may they take a little bit of Gilson with them as they leave, as we will miss them so much here, Lord. We thank you for their time here. And we can't wait to see what you do in their future, Lord. We pray for your blessings over them in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, lads. Have fun.
All right. Yeah. Well, thank you for that, Jonah.
Thank you.
I'm not going to feel touched by that. But
back to this. So, you know, this E12 journey, this 12 years. And we also had, like, many people that left midway that's not here with us. So we're not bringing up their names again.
It's not here.
I'm gonna give some names of the ones who's left so far. So we got A and Hope. Yeah. We just saw Hope just then.
She's actually in Gilson right now. I don't know where she is now, but yeah, she's actually here. We also got Core and Damon. Core's the funny guy, man. Damon Krauss is also
They're good lads.
One of the funniest people you'll meet.
Yeah.
Who else you got?
So we also got W Yusufs. Oh, yeah. So Yusuf Saleh and Yusuf Kakli, they were both funny dudes, man.
I'm scared of Yusuf Kakli, not gonna lie. We also got Dylan and Nina. Dylan and Vanessa, not Chong.
We got Sarah and Michael, those ones that left. They left early.
They weren't here for long. No, I don't know much about them.
Yeah.
We got Guntus and Kara. Who else you got?
Ishara, Dahini and Dan. Damn. They left at year 9 when they did their selective exams.
Oh, for real?
They did. They transferred.
We also got Frankie and the three Olivias. I don't remember the last names, but those three.
Sophie, Aiden, and Haran. Ooh. Same again, bro.
Man, I miss Haran, man. He was part of the Asian Mafia back in year 7, man. That was my gang. Asian Mafia. If you remember Asian Mafia, you're OG, man.
Yeah, I remember. My bad.
You were in a different class.
Alright, so we got Steph, Nathan, Doe, and Jasmine.
Oh, okay. Ooh,
I don't remember much.
Oh, you forgot. You forgot Nelson as well. Nelson, Fu, and Azu. Hey. Those guys are... Wow. I didn't talk to Azu much, but Fu, yeah, he was a good guy.
Yeah, and the one that's left recently as well, like Jelly and Later.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that was Zax and Jack.
Oh, and also Nick. You remember Nick?
He only stayed for 6 months? Yeah. A year. Yeah, during E7. Some of you guys might not even know him. All right. We got Juice Kobe, Justin.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Liam, Josh, and Saha. I remember Josh, and he bullied Mr. Tarch. That guy was a bully.
Damn, like, he's talking about midget feels. Oh, you remember that?
He just bullied anyone else.
That was too funny, man.
That guy was the tallest guy ever, so of course he's just going out bullying people.
No, but too bad he left too early.
Yeah, no, I miss him. I miss him.
Yeah.
So I think that's all the students, right?
That's all the students that's left. All
right. So now, I believe we now segue into our first segment, which is the first crush videos. So I believe Sasha and Staff went around asking people who were their first crushes.
I'm the host. One of them. We went around asking the first crush at Gilson. You know, we just felt like it was a sentimental thing to like share it. It doesn't matter anymore, it's first crush.
So who cares, man? Who cares? Ain't nobody judge. Right. So yeah, all right, let's let that video play.
So let me raise a toast to the girl I love most in the whole world.
Please don't say my name. Please don't say my name.
Darla.
Who was your first crush at Gilson?
Why are you asking me that question, man?
Everyone's participating.
Yeah, I have a crush. I had a crush on myself. For the years.
There you go.
Jacob Younger Bass.
No, I'm definitely Xing Li.
Marcos.
So Mark's was actually Olivia Rivers, and Ryan's was actually Kim, I'm pretty sure.
Eddie, from class of 2018.
Bingo, from 2018.
Alex Atenazovsky in prep.
I'm not sure.
I don't think it was anyone. No.
Do I have to answer? How many people have done it? Very nice. Who was your first crush at Gilson?
James Charles.
I think it was Tulip in... Actually, maybe not. Who was your first crush at Gilson?
Jesus Christ.
Good answer.
Yeah, Jesus Christ.
In what year level?
Since the beginning.
Can we restart?
Olivia in year 8.
Abdul Hafiz, year 12. Madeline Lassick, year 7.
Who was your first crush at Gilson?
Aaron Bobadilla in year 7.
Aiden Ung in year 8.
Wiley.
When?
In year 8.
We have a question for you.
My first crush? I haven't had a crush at Gilson.
Cap.
No, I'm being so serious. First crush? Like Max. Yeah.
In what year?
Like year 7. He's a cutie. I love Max. My bestie.
Hey guys.
Let's go.
It's LOL Alex One. Jesus was my first crush at Gilson. You know why? Because he died on the cross for my sins. Amen.
Amen.
I'm not saying that.
Why not? He's not going to see it.
Jaded.
I don't think I had a crush at Gilson.
In prep, it was Ariana.
Ooh. And you have to say the person's full name and in what year?
Frankie.
In what year level?
Year 7.
James Lapilla in year 7.
Ooh, I like that.
I think it was Yusuf in year 7.
After my first crush.
Yep.
It was 2017. First period in the gym. I see J-Bass. First day. Ryan, you were head over heels, yeah?
Yeah, I got him.
Love, first sight.
So when I first saw Jacob, I saw him going to the bathroom, and I'm like, I need to go toilet as well, and the rest is history.
So who was your first crush at Gilson College?
I can't lie, Chris Nicolau was my first crush. I'm not gonna even cap. Yeah,
First crush was Nathan Davies.
Really? In what year level?
9.
Grade 4, Victoria. Grade 5, Tulip.
Grade 6, Tulip.
Linda, year 7.
I'm here with our year's ducks, Emmanuel. I was just wondering, who was your first crush at Gilson College?
I don't think I've ever had a crush before. I've heard KFC's got some really good crushes.
Heard they were discontinued.
Okay, in year 7, I had a crush on Joshua Dwise.
I think I'd prefer not to answer this question.
Probably Nathan Davies in year 8.
Wait, I was just like, Chris.
Danny.
Small girls.
No. I think Yusuf Kakli.
Oh. This one's Cordank.
What's his name again? That little U10.
Little U10.
Oh, that's a case.
Who was your first?
Tulip in year 7.
Dan Ho in year 7.
He ran, and then I caught up to him, put him in the back of my trunk, took him home with me. The rest is history.
Can I say teacher?
No, come back.
Robert.
Ooh. Hey, I knew he was.
So far, everyone's either said Jesus or no one or themselves. Or Nelson Poledano. So, don't really know how this is going. Here's our other host, Xing Li.
Nelson Poledano, insert a photo of him.
Nelson.
Nelson Poledano.
Nelson, in grade 1.
Nelson Poledano in year 7.
Very popular choice.
Probably like Julia back in the day.
Alex Tanislavski, year 8.
It's a silly question, don't ask me that question.
Bro!
The cameraman.
Oh!
The one to my left.
You look good, Ta.
You want to start this again or we just really? Okay. This was in year 9 and it was Ryan.
Oh, I like Ryan too. He looks hot.
Mine was in primary. I'm pretty sure like... Mine was in primary. It was like year 1 and it was Danny.
Here with our PE teacher, Miss Kazaley. Miss, who was your first crush at Gilson?
My first crush? Wait, that's a terrible question.
Favorite student then?
It's Barry Kinglot.
For Kubi.
Alright.
Back to us.
Oh, that's a very interesting first question. I noticed 75% of the guys didn't go legit. Now I kind of regret saying my actual answer. I don't know what we're allowed to troll.
Nah, but it was funny though, there was people saying my name, Marcos, Jacob, especially, nah.
Hey, yo, if I was allowed to say it, I would have said Arnav in year 8, man. I was like, when I got first locked up, he was, dangerous.
Damn.
But, alright, well, enough, let's move on from that. Now we're going to move on to roasting teachers, the good old yearly event. I believe you have the list of teachers.
Okay, the list of teachers, right? Alright, so we're gonna go.
So we'll start off with, let's go with.
Economics teacher.
Oh, Mr. Touch,
Mr. Touch.
Oh, I could write essays about this guy,
oh,
man.
Oh my god.
Remember
when he got used to, like, writing letters?
He made me
an
apology letter, man.
Yeah.
I don't get it. So Sasha can get whatever she wants, but
I had to write an apology letter for vegetable people. I still remember that.
Yeah, you can't say that.
So, it's a lot about him, bro.
Look, I love the guy, but, oh, man, he's just, I guess you could say he's a bit short-tempered, you know what I'm saying?
I guess his authority is higher than his height. look at us! We're like two clowns.
Okay, let's enough of that guy.
Move on to the next teacher.
Let's let him breathe,
Alright, this is my teacher, my accounting teacher, alright? And business management teacher, Miss Gilio.
Ooh, what you gonna say about her?
She's always mad, bro. I tell her. Like, she's pregnant. Like, relax. That's all she needs to do. No more yelling, no more talking. Just let the class run itself. Done. It's fine. She's a good teacher, though.
Yeah, okay. Well, yeah. No, you can't cover up. No, you said what you said. No, that's not going to cover it up.
Oh.
Who else you got? Mr. Hafiz. I don't have Mr. Hafiz for anything, man. That's you again.
Nah, so, there's not much.
Lucky, yeah, Mr. Hafiz ain't got.
Mr. Hafiz ain't got much.
We ain't got no note on him.
Yeah, all the boys love Mr. Hafiz.
Yeah, to be honest, you know what? Shout out to you, Mr. Hafiz, man. You're a clean guy.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Peter. I had him for physics for a couple of days. A couple of years. He's a funny teacher, but like, he's a good guy. I love him. Marks hella lightly, but does he teach? That's up to debate. You know what I'm saying? that's not what you want to say. That's what you can say.
Yeah, I have to agree with that, because when I had my math method 3 and 4, that whole year I was doing self-study.
Yeah.
It was
still love you though, Mr. Peter. Still love you.
Oh, hey, our favorite teacher, Miss Joshua. That was a lie.
Oh my gosh.
It's just, her classes are just they make me sleepy, bro.
It's a fight. I'm fighting against myself to like stay conscious in her class. Bro. She was also the type of person that like would yell at you if you sneeze in class. Like, nothing you can do. But like, if you sneeze, you're dead. Alright, who else we got next?
Nah, my homeroom teacher, Miss Lindbeck.
Miss Lindbeck?
What do you think about her?
Oh, I don't know. She's always happy, but sometimes she's a bit too happy. Like, loud for no reason, man.
Yeah, she's talkative, right?
I'm right here, you don't need to yell. Like,
yeah, she talks too much.
Yeah. Okay.
Now she's ruining the vibe, you know what I'm saying? Alright, this is the last one. Mr. Egghead.
Ooh. He's definitely on steroids. No doubt about that. You see the way the guy's built? Nah, that ain't natty. Yeah. No way.
I agree.
He's on steroids.
He doesn't realize in class that I don't want to study anything. Like, he's always picking on me, you know what I'm saying?
He picks
on me. Like, he's asking me questions that I don't know how to answer, and then he just pauses the whole class just to roast me.
Well, maybe you're meant to listen in class.
Bro, I don't want to do religion, bro. Yeah. I'm not into that, you feel me?
Yeah, well, you just gotta deal with it.
That's all the teachers.
That's all the teachers. Alright, well, this is my video. Here's a little TikTok I made for you lads.
It's a present from him to the Utah.
This little kid.
I asked my mates to scream, and this is what I got.
My little thing. You know that took me 3 hours?
Damn.
It looks easy, yeah? That took me 3 hours.
30 seconds? Like,
bro,
not even 30 seconds.
Bro, I don't know how people do it, how TikTokers do it. I'm like, that took me so long.
Nah, hey, but shout out to Hamilton. He had a great session.
I was
that, was funny. That was funny.
The only one that actually, like, pulled in clutch. Alright.
Oh, now we're up to the next section of the video. Of the assembly. So now this is the spill your guts or fill your guts. And this is featuring me, Chris, Loza, and Nardas.
I'm out of this. Right. Better boys.
Come through. You don't walk. Right, everyone say hi.
Hey.
Hi.
So the foods that we got some
red hot chilies.
We got some pickled capers, some raw egg, some brown rice, bean, and pumpkin baby food, and some apple cider vinegar.
Bro, you guys made this nasty, bro. I don't want to do any of this. All right, coming up, so...
You can start. You can ask. You can ask me one first.
Yeah, so we'll be asking...
What food?
Explain the game.
All right, you go.
Explain the game.
All right, so the way this works is that I'll ask Shing a question and choose a food for him to eat. And if he doesn't want to eat it, he has to answer the question. But if he can't answer the question, he has to eat the food. So, yeah, that's about it.
Yeah, the same goes for these two.
So they'll be asking each other a question. If they don't want to eat it, then they'll say it. If they don't want to say it, then they'll eat it.
All I'm going to say is she's eating today.
Words down. Right?
So you can start.
I can start. All right.
What do you want me to eat?
Oh, I want you to eat this chili. Fresh. One bite.
The whole thing.
Clean the whole thing.
Everything.
But let me ask the question.
So let's see. Go ask.
Ask the question. Ooh, who's the teacher that you hate the most and the reason?
God damn.
So you're eating this today.
No, save that.
Oh! Oh, now we should have got hotter fingers. Now you know he's not happy.
Oh, I'm struggling. I can't take this, man.
You guys, you gotta last me.
Yeah, you have to finish it. I'll say it through. Yeah. I'm gonna see and watch me eat.
Okay, you're gonna eat the baby foods.
Ooh.
Is this spins?
Okay, I'll just chuck it in. Okay.
Okay, so out of our friendship group, rate us, rate our friendship group from the prettiest to the least prettiest.
I think they're all pretty. But it's
They're all beautiful.
Yeah, they're all beautiful, but Nada's got an answer.
Cheers.
Ooh.
Nah, did you actually do it?
She actually did do it.
Oh my god.
Is it even bad? Is it actually bad?
Mom thought.
Nah, I have some more. I ate the whole chili.
Yeah, he ate the whole chili. You're gonna make an effort, like a squeeze, you know what I'm saying? Come on.
Guys,
I'm sitting here dying. You're gonna have a little. Yeah, see it through. Nah, I got more than that.
Yeah. Nah, solo.
Ching. Your turn, yeah? So, yeah, obviously, you're gonna eat the raw egg.
Oh.
And you're gonna enjoy it. So, out of all the boys being Max, Jacob, James, Ryan, Marcos, and Aaron,
mm-hmm.
who is your least favorite and why?
Who's my least favorite?
Your least favorite and why?
Least favorite.
So just know they're watching live. Yeah, they're gonna enjoy this one. They're watching live.
Nah, I'm not eating this, bro. I'm gonna say
it looks good, man. It looks good.
I'm gonna say Ryan because he doesn't know how to behave.
No, but that's not true though.
No, he doesn't know how to behave.
Answer truthfully, because we know Ryan's not your least favorite.
This guy, I'm picking him up in the morning and he just looks at me through the window and just stays in the room for 10 minutes.
I'm just
out of the car waiting.
He's your best mate. You can't be sitting here lying. Out of all the boys, who do you least like?
Least like.
So who's your least like favorite to hang out with?
Wait, it's down.
How was it?
Wow, that was good. Jeez.
That was nasty.
Anyways, so since this one to bring our friend group into it, if you had to kick one person out of our friend group, who is it going to be? Spoonful of this and you're going to take a sip.
Oh!
And a sip. tell them who your group is.
Shout out to Tatiana, Shekinah, and Didi, Rani. Didi and Rani.
So she said put a scoop and then you're
going to taste it. Yeah, a little taste as well, you know.
The thing is, I couldn't even tell you what that is. What is that?
Pickled capers.
With that.
Yeah,
then you're going to drink it. Oh!
You wash it down, you know?
Bro.
Nah, just answer the question. Bro. It's not a bad question.
Uh-huh.
It's not a bad question.
It's not a bad question. It'll be interesting.
Amen.
Hey, you gotta drink it now. Say it, drink some.
Drink some.
Sit down.
Nicely.
Wow, we all copped it today.
All copped it. It's your turn to honor.
Oh, she's still going. She's still finishing it. See it through.
Congrats.
Well, that spoon you got to fill your guts. We all suck. None of us answered a question.
Yep, we all chugged something down.
I'll say Shin got the worst one.
Nadas
was close second, like baby food. Like, who wants to eat baby food? But, you know, Loza seemed to struggle as well. I got let off easy.
Alright, so in the next session. What is the next?
Flashbacks.
Alright, so now we're going to have some flashbacks of memories from other past years come through. So it's just videos. So like all these different camps.
It's corny interviews.
Actually, this is a video by me. It's corny interviews hosted by Jimmy and James.
And Jimmy Jacob.
And Jacob. What's
transition?
That's
what
it.
Is it?
Transition.
Thank you.
This? No.
Thank you. Bro, no.
I need gum.
Bro, I feel so bad, bro.
You want some milk?
Oh, I'm here with Jacob Abbas. Now, I'm just going to ask you 5 quick questions, alright? Do you genuinely think that you're better than me at basketball?
I know I am.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
Okay. If you had to replace any of the current school captains, who would you replace them with?
I'd replace Captain Chris with Azarina, it has to be. That man's a leader at heart.
Right? Yeah.
What about Sasha Bonici?
Sasha can stay. She's been a pretty good captain. Oh, perfect. It's just Captain Chris that I would replace.
Alright, fair enough. Okay. If you had to kiss one guy in our year grade, who would you kiss?
There's a lot of options. And it's about who can handle the voluptuous lips, obviously. I'm of choosing Ryan, Chris, James, and Mark. Because not because they don't all have their hands up at the moment, but yeah.
Well, I only asked for one, but if you got...
They're all going to get it now.
All right. Now, what's your best girl advice for dating in general?
Oofed. Yeah. Best... Okay. Stay away from toxicity, all right? Just in general. Okay. And make sure the person you want to be with, you're 100% compatible with, all right? That's my advice. Easy. All
right. And my last question is... Who is the least dateable person in our year grade?
Least? Ooh, man. Again, this is a bit subjective because there are obviously certain people...
Yeah, it's all your opinion.
Oh, man. I don't think I can... don't think I can be naming names.
There's four girls on the bench right there.
Calm. So say number one. Actually, can I... I'm going to just go through the list. I'd say it would be... Raj to Tanya, Radit then Loza.
I think that's all the time we have.
Question I'm gonna ask is, what type of boys are you into?
I like them toxic.
You heard it here first, people. She likes them toxic. She likes them dangerous. She likes. Question for all three of yous. Do any one of you have an infatuation with Sudanese guys?
Ryan, you can ask that question.
No.
The people want to know.
No.
Lock up.
No.
No, thank you.
Okay, so the question I'm going to be asking you guys is who out of these group of guys, in case the people don't know, Aaron, James, Chris, Shing, and Ryan, and Mark, we're going to include Mark, the cameraman, well.
Jacob.
Okay, fine, and J-Bass.
Okay, mine is because I think we're going to clash, and it'll be Mark, because we have different opinions. So it'll be Mark. Sorry, Mark.
Yeah, Mark. He's just a headache. I think he'd make me want to unalive myself.
Unalive myself. All right, calm.
So I pick Ryan. Because he insults me too much. So I feel like we just argue all the time. Because we always argue.
The person that I would think that would be the worst today, no offense, is Shing. Only because, like, I sometimes have, you know, attitude. And, like, so you would be oblivious. So you would give me attitude back. So it's just like, we're going to clash, basically.
All right, before we end it. Hey, Mark. All right, we're back with the part two. And we're gonna ask these lovely ladies who they reckon would be the best today out of the same scrawny guys over there.
Stop hiding the camera.
Come. We're gonna start off with Tat.
Okay. These are my top two because.
Yeah, I can't.
The best today, I personally think is Ryan and Chris. Only because number one. Ryan and Chris, they would treat me like a princess. Like, Ryan's there to pattern me, and then Chris is there to spoil me. Like, mum's like, no, like, you guys would treat me good.
Oh, come on.
No, but like, you guys are my best friends.
Hey, I have to agree. That was a I respect your answer.
Like,
hey, it's a good answer.
Nice.
Hey, Ryan, you gonna pattern her nicely, and you gonna spoil her.
Ryan,
yes, sir.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes,
yeah,
sir. Calm. Good answer.
Oh my God.
Loza. Best person to date.
Okay, I've got two. It'd either be Chris or Shing.
Ooh.
The reason Chris. No, Chris is because he's tall.
Yeah. Oh.
He's like tall, the tallest. And Shing because like he says very nice things like to me. If I look good, he'll say I look good. If I look bad, he'll say I look bad.
A very hot selection as well, I have to admit. Okay, Radit, See, there are no pseudos here, so it's going to maybe compromise your decision making.
I don't know why you're laughing. But still,
but who do you reckon is the best to date?
Mine would either have to be Shing, Ryan, or Chris. Only because I know them like that, like deeply, and I just know like they front like they're rude people, but they're not, you know? Mm. Yeah.
I have three. Top three would be Chris, James, and I think Jacob, because we're the closest. Ooh,
calm. Bro, there was James and thing. All right, calm. That's been all for the most, I don't even know what we're going to call this.
Hi everyone, I'm Tatiana, and today I'm going to be singing a special item, and it's Stay With Me by Sam Smith. Okay. Guess it's true, I'm not good at a one-night stand. But I still need love, cause I'm just a man. These nights never seem to go to plan. I don't want you to leave, can you hold my hand? Oh, won't you stay with me? Cause you're all I need. This ain't love, it's clear to see. But darling, stay with me. Why am I so emotional? No, it's not a good look, gain some self-control. And deep down I know this never works. But darling, stay with me today. Oh, won't you stay with me? Cause you're all I need. This ain't love, it's clear to see. But darling, stay with me. Ooh, oh, 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 won't you darling, stay with me. Oh, won't you stay with me? Cause you're all I need. This ain't love, it's clear to see. But darling, stay with me. Thank you.
Thank you, Titania, for that. I was now I feel pretty talentless, not gonna lie, following up after that.
Yeah.
Shing, would you like to
sing?
Would you like to give us a quick little vocal test?
Oh no, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it.
Alright.
Well, so now we're gonna start introducing our past memories, videos of our camps, especially the surfing camp video and the vulnerable camp video.
Right.
Now roll? Got it.
Ways to catch 100.
I think I
just hit the corner. That's too tiring.
Yes!
Petra. Update on your fitness?
I'm dead.
None of us did.
That's wet there, but it's actually not that much.
Alright, close it, close it, close it.
Nature.
takes a toll on the men, that they really want to live the old life that they always had. And hope everyone has a good day. In his name, I pray. Always there with a smile, saying you're not alone. Singing la 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 la, thank you all for allowing us to worship you this morning.
Mystery, so let's just do it. And even when the rain falls, you and I will stand tall. No matter what you go through, I'll never leave you. So you gotta be strong, strong. Live by the words of the song, song. Together is where we belong, belong. Never stop dreaming, keep holding on. At the end of the day, some you win, some you go. So I'm glad that I'm here with some friends. Enough, giving up, it ain't okay. We don't care what the world say. We spread love, it's the only way. So you gotta be strong, strong. Live by the words of the song, song. Together is where we belong, belong. Never stop dreaming, keep holding on. At the end of the day, some you win, some you don't. So I'm glad that I'm here with some friends. So I'm glad that I'm here with some friends that I know. Always there with a smile, saying you're not alone. Singing la 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 la, que será. At the end of the day, some you win, some you don't. So I'm glad that I'm here with some friends.
Friends that I know, always there with a smile, saying you're.
circling his votaries. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run, I was born for this.
Whip, whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip. Word upon your lip, lip. Rather that you rip, rip. Break me down and build me up. Whatever it takes. Always hanging on to the visual. I wanna be invisible. Looking at my ears like I'm out of dumb. Everybody needs to be a part of them. Never be enough from the prodigal son. I was born to run, I was born for this. Whip, whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip. Word upon your lip, lip. Rather that you rip, rip. Break me down and build me up. Whatever it takes.
Parenthetical, hypothetical, working on something that I'm proud of. Out of the box, an epoxy to the world and the vision we've lost. I'm an apostrophe. I'm just a symbol to remind you that there's more to see. I'm just a product of the system of catastrophe. And yet a masterpiece, and yet I'm half deceased. And when I am deceased, at least I go down to the grave and die. Leave the body of my soul to be a part of me. I'll do what it takes.
Whatever it takes.
What's up, guys? It is Shekinah, and I am going to be singing It's So Hard to Say Goodbye by Boyz II Men a cappella. So let's go.
How do I say goodbye to what we have? The good time that made us laugh outweigh the bad. I thought we'd get to see forever, but forever's gone away, and it's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday. I don't know where this road is going to lead. All I know is where we've been and what we've been through. And if we get to see tomorrow, I hope it's worth the wait. And it's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday. And I'll take with me the memories to be my sunshine after the rain. And it's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday. And I'll take with me the memories to be my sunshine after the rain. Oh, it's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday. Thank you.
Great scene by Shaq.
And once again, I feel even more talentless.
Guys, no talent.
Yeah, nah.
Talentless.
That's why we're up here talk. We don't sing or do anything else, to be honest. But yeah. What's up next?
So you know how students left? We've got some teachers that left as well. And now this is the time, we're going to bring up a video of our favourite teachers, Mrs. Hutchinson, who left. And he's going to give us a special message about this year. Thank you.
Hello, Year 11 and 12 students. It is an absolute pleasure to be with you this morning. It is your So Week and your last So Week for the Year 12s, your second last one for Year 11s. We're going to have a little bit of commentary between Bo and Ailey, but... it is an honour to be able to share with you this morning. I was asked to share some memories. Now, it would be too hard for me to pick out one or two or a few memories because I have way too many. And each of them are precious to me and each and every one of you. One I will share is for the Year 9 camp, for each year respectively. It was just awesome to be able to come in to cook with you all, prepare breakfast, lunch, dinner, to laugh with you, sing with you in the kitchen, to talk to you around the dinner table and see how your days were, to go out and do community service with each group and be a part of that, karaoke in the van, whatever it was, playing basketball on that crazy ring, playing cards at night. It was like, it really is one of my favorite memories for both classes. It gave me also an opportunity to get to know some of you that I hadn't ever taught more because we're on camp and we're just getting to know each other and hanging out, which is awesome. Another quick little shout out to my Year 11 hospitality students last year. Through your first VCE subject, Year 12 subject, you guys were so resilient and worked so, so hard. And to see the results that you achieved, I'm so proud of each and every one of you. And also, not just that, the skills that you developed through that just brings joy to me. Besides that, there is countless memories and I hold each of those close to my heart. And I want you to know that. I miss each and every one of you, but I'm grateful for this morning. Now to some advice and kind of what the next part of life holds for each and every one of you. I firstly just want to say that you guys have done it so tough and so well over the last 2 years. It's the first time that any school students have had to go through what you've gone through over the last couple of years, and you have done so well. You're this close for the Year 12s. For Year 11s, you got one more year. And you guys have shown so much backbone, and that is awesome. So moving into what's next, uni, work, whatever it may be for Year 11s, it's Year 12. I just want you to know and really remember to rely on God. And in life, it's very easy, and I know I've done it in the past, so that's why I'm sharing it with you, that it is easy to go and try and find advice from people around you, peers, whoever it may be, mentors, but that can often fall short. And whenever I seeked people's approval for what I was doing, I often found myself a little empty, or not quite doing and having the success that I should have. But whenever I gave it to God, whenever I fully just handed it over to God, and relied on Him, He showed up and blessed me and sent me to places that I never thought I would go. And I encourage you, when you leave school, when you're in year 12, when you're doing your exams, when you're working, and you're struggling or you need help, just ask Him to help you. When you're doing well and have success, praise Him and thank Him for the guidance that He has given you and been there for you. And that ties into a verse that I want to share with you this morning. And that is found, that's right, mate. That is found in Exodus chapter 14, verse 14. Do you want to hold it for me? Oh. And it reads, "The Lord will fight for you. You need not only be still, you only need to be calm. The Lord will fight for you." The Lord is fighting for each and every one of you, and has done for the last 17 years, 16 years, however old you are. He is fighting for you daily. And whether you have asked for it or not, He's still fighting because He loves you and wants to see you succeed and want to see you happy. So just stay calm when you are struggling, when things are full on, exams are coming up for all of you, when it's seeming too much, just stop, be still, pray, and thank God that He is fighting for you. You might not see it right now, but you'll see it in the future. You'll see it when He sends you places you can't have ever imagined, when He blesses you when you just didn't think it was possible. So know that God is with you and fighting for you, and just to stay calm and stay with Him. Know that I and all your teachers love you and care for you and are there for you also. To finish off this morning, I just want to invite Ailey and Mrs. Hutchinson in, and we're going to pray for you because that's also so, so important. And that is prayer. So come in. Good, good girl. We're going to say prayers. So you're going to close your eyes? All right. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, I just want to thank you for each and every one of these students. We love them so much, and are so proud of what they've already achieved and what they are going to achieve. Lord, you have a plan for them. May they know that. Lord, bless each and every one of them over the coming weeks and towards the end of this year and headed into the future. Lord, I thank you for this time this morning. I thank you for the chance to just connect with each and every one of these students, Lord. It's such a blessing. Amen. Guys.
Super proud of you. We miss you.
We miss you heaps. We love you heaps. Say love you.
Love you.
We'll see you guys soon. All right. See ya.
Hey guys, just a quick message from me. I just want to say a special thank you to the backbone of our year level, Sasha. She's the foundation of everything good that's happened this year. Through all the ups and downs, from being the first captains to have jackets every week in 13 years, to having successful fundraisers, and to be able to have a dress-up day, which was looking very unlikely before 2 days ago. So on behalf of the grade, I would like to say thank you for all the hard work you've done behind the scenes, because without you, none of this would have been possible. Thank you, Shazza, the real MVP.
Clap, guys. Woo! Woo! Hey.
Seriously?
This is it.
It's come close. Very close. This is the end, guys. We're nearly here.
Okay, hold on.
Collect yourself.
I'm collecting, okay. Alright, I'm good.
Yeah, I'm gonna say like a personal message to the grade. Alright, this is from the bottom of my heart. Yes, to everyone. Yes, the girls, the boys. Right? So if personally I want everyone here to be happy, yeah, I want you to do your thing in life. Don't leave regrets. Be happy. Do whatever you gotta do to make yourself happy, alright? If you're in a toxic relationship, leave. If you're gonna be a snake, be the biggest snake ever, alright? Be you. You got this, right? That's all I have.
Alright, well, I might as well say my thing. I know I don't know every single one of y'all. Obviously, I'm not friends with every single person in your grade. But whether you like me or not, I don't care, man. I honestly hope every single one of y'all have the best future. Have loving family, loving kids. Just anything you could possibly ask for, I hope you guys will do. Actually, no, I don't need to hope you. I know you guys are going to do well. I've seen the people win this year. They're fantastic, man. But it's just gonna suck not seeing you guys every day. I've gone so used to this routine of just, like, coming into school and, like, just seeing you guys, man. It's like, oh, it's going to be so weird not hearing y'all. I know technically we'll still see each other, like, a couple more times, like, for exams, but, like, you good, man?
Yeah, I'm good, man.
Go ahead, hang in there. We're nearly done.
All right.
Yeah, we'll see you guys in the exam. Actually, no, we've got, one more video left to show?
Yeah, one more video left to show, and guys, enjoy.
Oh, yeah.
This is seriously your last moment to be together.
Yeah,
this is good. So far, with the whole cohort.
No. This video is going to recap the last week of school, and then there's a message from our school captains, Felix and Sasha. Come on, boys.
Hey, yeah, I got protected. Hey.
Now it's recording.
Hi, shorties. Shorties.
Hey guys, happy Monday. This is our last Monday ever. Oh,
hi friends! Our final week of year 12.
Yes!
Remember?
BC, like, can we all
get these silly gooses?
I can't.
You said all of them at one go. I'm a life bomb.
Well, you can't just say it and be like, oh, what are you gonna say?
No, but we gotta move on.
Hey.
Hey guys, welcome to our farewell video, and this will be the last time we ever speak to you guys.
We know we're going to miss a lot of the highs and lows, like Jacob shooting threes on the basketball court.
And Tatiana barking at all of us.
Jimmy chasing Marcos around the common room.
But these are some of the memories that we'll be able to cherish forever.
We hope the best for everyone as we move on to new parts in our lives, and hope that uni goes well for everyone.
No matter where we are in our journeys, we'll know that we'll always have each other, and we spent 5 years growing up together.
We appreciate you for nominating us as your captains, and hope the best for you in the future.
Good luck, everyone.
That was good.